How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And if you're looking for a good free VPN for your Mac, then you're definitely in the right place. Before we begin, if you guys are interested at any point, you'd like to check for links to pricing discounts, you'll find everything you need in the description down below, as well as full reviews. If you'd like to know the ins and outs of these VPNs in terms of privacy policy, speed streaming, torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features, so be sure to keep that in mind. I think the only VPN we've yet to review is Atlas VPN, but we did do some testing and everything, really just needed to make sure that Atlas VPN is a solid VPN, but the review will be linked as soon as it is done. Besides that, let's get straight into it. Now, I'm going to be talking about why you would choose these free VPNs over other VPNs. First of all, when it comes to free VPNs, for the most part, when companies try to advertise, free VPNs that they're totally free and there are no strings attached and whatnot, it's usually a blatant lie. Most VPN providers do either log your data, they take your credentials, they sell it to third-party companies. Information is money at the end of the day. So these three VPNs, though, are the VPNs to use when it comes to you just want to, maybe secure your data while you're on public Wi-Fi, okay? And these are the VPNs to use because of their very solid privacy and no-log policy. We've looked into their privacy policies. There's nothing shady about their data collection, nothing out of the ordinary. So you can definitely trust these three VPNs when it comes to using a free VPN. At the end of the day, a free VPN is just meant for you to first of all, secure your data for free, and two, it's just that they're giving you kind of a taste of what the full VPN would be like if you were to purchase it, but of course with limited data and limited features and servers, of course. So you're not going to be able to get the full features and servers using the free VPN. And with regards to investing in a VPN, I'll show you guys in just a second what VPNs would actually be worth investing in. But if we're talking free VPNs, I know I'm on Windows, by the way, but all these VPNs are indeed available on Mac. If you can just look here. So this is Privado. All you need to do is just go to Privado VPN, scroll all the way down, and look for Privado for macOS. Download, hit the download button, just follow the steps. It's the same with Atlas VPN. So you're going to go to Atlas VPN, VPN apps, macOS, and you're good to go. Just download and follow the steps. And it's the same with Proton VPN. Just scroll all the way down, pick your device here, Mac, click download, and just follow the steps. So that'll be it, really. Now, with these VPNs, of course, as I said before, some VPNs may offer more than the others. Now, with Privado VPN, you're going to be getting limited data. It's a great VPN because they're actually giving you access to 12 locations. You'll still get access to your kill switch, and that's about it. And it's a pretty good VPN overall. Of course, all these VPNs will be throttling speed in one way or another. So you're not going to be getting the full speed potential, of course, as a premium VPN. These VPNs at the end of the day are just made for you to secure your data when you really need to, such as on public Wi-Fi. With Atlas VPN, you'll be getting three locations, but you'll be getting unlimited data, unlimited bandwidth, no 10 gigabyte per month like Privado VPN. And it's the same with Proton VPN. You'll be getting three locations with unlimited data. In Proton VPN, you'll still be getting access to the kill switch as well as a split tunneling feature, which is very generous considering it's completely free. Now, let's say you're looking to get a VPN that is a little bit more premium. Now, with these free VPNs, if you're expecting to unblock Netflix or any type of streaming library, unfortunately, that's not going to work, okay? Because when you, let's go ahead and connect to one of these VPNs, okay? Let's get a free server, okay? I have all paid versions, of course, for these VPNs in order to review them. But when you get yourself the free version of, for example, Proton VPN, let's connect to Proton VPN and hit connect here on the free server for the US server. Now, as you know, by the way, HBO Max is only available in the United States. Now, oh, this is taking a little bit of time. I'm going to show you guys how that works, by the way, in a premium VPN. Now, HBO Max is available only in the States. Now, when I try to unblock HBO Max using this VPN, it will actually detect that I'm using a VPN, and I won't be able to unblock HBO Max. So this is the thing that I'm trying to say. If you're looking for the best in class encryption and capabilities of G-restriction capabilities, unblocking capabilities. Now, if you're looking for the best in class encryption and capabilities of unblocking geo-restrictions, you're not going to be finding that in any kind of free VPN. Again, a free VPN is only meant to secure your data when you really need to. But when it comes to the, let's say, privileges and features that come with a premium VPN, you're not going to be finding those in those free VPNs. Of course, you can register for the premium versions of these VPNs, but my recommendation would be to actually get yourselves better VPNs, such as ExpressVPN, NordVPN, and Surfshark. Now, these three VPNs will give you everything you're looking for or need out of a VPN. First of all, they all have the kill switch and split tunneling features. Not just that, they have plenty of servers. One of these VPNs has more servers than all of the previous VPNs, the three free VPNs that I mentioned combined. So ExpressVPN has over 3,000 servers covering a whopping 94 countries. ExpressVPN has over 5,300 servers in 60 countries, and Surfshark covers up to 65 countries and over 3,200 servers, which are very good numbers that are above average in general. ExpressVPN will allow you to secure up to 5 devices per subscription. That'll be 6 with Nord and an unlimited amount with Surfshark, which is also one of the biggest selling points for Surfshark. Now, let me just show you guys a quick example. Of course, when it comes to unblocking these services, such as HBO Max, which is only available in the States, first of all, you'll notice that a premium VPN like ExpressVPN will connect a little bit faster than the free VPN, such as Proton VPN. Took about 10 to 15 seconds to connect. Here with just barely 5 seconds, and now all I need to do is either refresh, or I might have to actually delete this part of the URL, but I don't think I'm gonna need to do that. As you can tell, I am access, and there you go, I do have access to HBO Max right now. So you see how easy it is, and how effortless it is when it comes to unblocking streaming services using a premium service or VPN like ExpressVPN. Now, all in all, I'm going to give you a small brief, but if you guys are interested, again, you'll find reviews down below as well as special deals and discounts if you're looking to learn more about these VPNs. But if you're looking for the best in class, but if you're looking for the best VPN for unblocking streaming services and Netflix libraries, using Netflix as a reference, for example, ExpressVPN will be the one to go for. Now, ExpressVPN is able to unblock up to 18 Netflix libraries, 10 with Nord, and 15 libraries with Surfshark. Of course, these are just the confirmed libraries that you'll be able to unblock, as I've been told by the live chat support of Express, Nord, and Surfshark. You could do your own testing and unblock more services, but these are the confirmed libraries that you'll be able to unblock. Now, with regards to which one you would go for, if you're looking for the best streaming services, VPN for streaming services, and unblocking Netflix libraries, and just the best security and privacy and no-lock policy in general, go with ExpressVPN. If you don't want to pay for ExpressVPN and you want to get some more features like specialty servers, the Nord Lynx protocol, which makes NordVPN the fastest in the industry. If you're looking for an app kill switch as well as custom DNS and such, then you can go with NordVPN, which you'll be able to secure up to 6 devices, unlike Express's 5, as I mentioned earlier. But if you're looking for an even cheaper VPN that just gets the job done at the least possible cost, then Surfshark will let you also secure an unlimited amount of devices, which is very, very helpful. And you still get multi-hop static IP, which are the same as a double VPN and dedicated IP. You also get the whitelister, which is split tunneling, the kill switch, and an ad blocker, as well as the WireGuard protocol, which is a super powerful protocol. Very quick, not as quick as NordVPN, but still pretty quick. You also get the Shadow Sox protocol, which will help you reach banned websites, and no borders mode if you're in China and you're not able to get by using the regular servers. So that's pretty much it. If you guys are interested in learning more about these VPNs, you'll find links to the reviews as well as special deals and discounts in the description down below. So feel free to take advantage of those while they last. Besides that, thank you guys very much for watching. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Have a wonderful day.